Let's go on to the other stories that are in the news this morning. Let's speak to Sam Lewis, political commentator and specialist in foreign policy, who joins us on Early Breakfast this morning. Sam, very good morning to you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Alex, for having me on.
Pleasure. Let's start, we'll return to the Afghanistan story to begin with. And we're expecting to see, aren't we, some sort of protest in London this morning. Tell us a little bit about that. What do you know?
Yeah, absolutely. So at 10 a.m. this morning, there'll be a protest outside Parliament, very similar to the protests we've seen last week, with veterans will turn up and former Afghan interpreters will be there to sort of pressurize the government to make sure that we can get all 4,000, 5,000 Afghan interpreters out, because these are the ones that the Taliban are going after. You know, veterans are getting phone call after phone call from Afghans begging for their lives. And ultimately, all they can do is send them an internet link to forms. And there's very little else that they seem to be doing. So the pressure needs to be put on the government.
And this is outside the Home Office, I believe, isn't it?
And outside the Home Office.
Yeah. And I guess the presence of Afghan interpreters is going to be a very interesting one, because that's really the emotive point, isn't it? With people trying to get out and whether they are eligible or not to come to the UK. And if they are, but they're being denied, or if we are abandoning them in any way, that's really where the emotion connects to the politics, isn't it? So it's going to be interesting.
Absolutely. I mean, the issue is that, you know, if we compare it to the fall of Saigon and how many people, the Americans at the time, were able to get out, the fact is that they were simply rubber stamping passports and it was much easier. But now there's the bureaucracy of biometric scans and trying to get people out that way. It takes a lot more time, and time is of the essence at the moment if the Americans do pull out before the 31st of August.
Mm. And we're also expecting to see a special issue of The Big Issue today, which is sort of focusing on refugees, sort of tied into Afghanistan.
Yeah, well, there's a very, very important story within that of one particular refugee who made a 2,000-mile voyage across to the UK, which took him a year. And it's a very sad story. I do recommend people read it, but it also points to the fact that we very much need to be doing more. You know, according to the UN, that there are some 82 million forcibly displaced people in the world, 68% of whom come from just five countries: Syria, Venezuela, Afghanistan, South Sudan, and Myanmar. And this is only going to increase. And the article also points to the fact that with climate change, set to rise in sea levels, which will completely wipe out some areas. We've seen flooding this year, so some places will become completely uninhabitable. And people will be having to move and search for better fields elsewhere. And this report sort of highlights it.
Mm. Speaking of reports, we have a couple this morning to do with the workforce in the UK, so bringing it back domestically. And we're going to be looking at one of them later on, which is focusing on Scotland later on in the Early Breakfast hour. But for the moment, let's talk about the TUC one, because they've looked into the pay gap within the care sector. Is that right? And what have they found?
So the TUC have found that effectively the pay gap is extraordinary. It's something along the lines of over 900 directors of these firms earning over 900,000 per year, and that over the course of 3 months, a normal care worker on the front line is only able to earn as much as the directors do in one day. But unfortunately, you know, this is not new and doesn't surprise us. We sort of expect that Gordon Gekko types will be within banks or FTSE 100 companies, but they, you know, these people do exist at the top of care firms as well, even though we expect them to sort of do it for the right reasons if they work within the care sector or within social care. But unfortunately, this is not always the case.
Mm. And the TUC, I think they're essentially saying, aren't they, that it's essentially the private model, of course, for care is broken, and the pay gap demonstrates that, which is interesting given the context 100%. Of the last year and a half, very much so. There's a warning this morning that gambling, I mean, we cover a lot of stories about gambling, but it's a serious public health issue, we know that. And Standard Life, their foundation chief executive, has raised concerns about people's finances, livelihoods and relationships in the most disadvantaged areas of the country. Tell us, why is he making that warning this morning? And because it's quite a serious issue that Standard Life have found, isn't it?
Yeah, well, effectively, they found that the UK's most deprived areas is more than 10 times the number of betting shops than the affluent parts of the country. And if we look at the social ills that come as a result of gambling. This is sort of a rut that people can't get themselves out of. And I find it interesting that on the whole, we are a gambling nation. You know, we have racing on Saturdays, on the television, and we've had it for hundreds of years, but we sort of don't view it in the same way that we view, for example, cigarettes, even though the health problems from cigarettes can be sort of monetized, and we can see what the issue, what the effect on the NHS is, but we don't see the social ills that come from gambling. So the regulation is very much different. And for example, gambling firms can advertise on football shirts or advertise in between matches, even though in between football matches on the television, and we don't really know how to get on top of it. And like I say, the regulation is very different to other industries such as the cigarette industry, where there are such big issues as well.
Mm. Sam, appreciate your time this morning. Thank you very much for bringing us up to date with the morning's news stories. Sam Lewis is political commentator and specialist in foreign policy. He's also a contributor to Young Voices and author of East Asia Insider, the news blog, which I'd highly recommend. Sam Lewis is a specialist in foreign policy, as I mentioned.